Hello, friends.
Do you have a messy corner of your home that fills you with dread?
What happened here? How did it get so messy? I swear I cleaned this last year. Why did I let it get so bad?
There are plenty of organization systems available for purchase, but budgets are tight and prices keep rising. This may seem intimidating, but there is no need to despair. We've rounded up our favorite DIY organization tips to help you. Let's do this. Throughout the year, we often get an urge to start cleaning and organizing. We are a little obsessed with organization, so we know how intimidating of a task it can be. Before tackling a big organizing project and completely overwhelming yourself, try making a game plan first. There are two types of people: list makers and non-list makers. If you're a list maker, make a list of areas you want to organize so that you have a clear checklist. If you're not a list maker, try discussing it with another household member so it's not all in your head. Then take it one area at a time. Here are some simple DIY tips we use to organize our home and garage.
Tip 1. Take it one area at a time. Organizing always leads to a mess at first when you've got to take everything out before you can put it back together. If I took everything out everywhere around the house, I'd go a bit crazy. Tip 2. Set a goal for each day. If you have the capacity to do a full room, then do it. Otherwise, it can be as small as setting aside 30 minutes to clean your closet or organize just one drawer in the kitchen. Take it a little at a time, and you'll be amazed at how much you can accomplish.
For example, I dedicated some time one morning and organized my whole closet. Tip 3. Make some small storage shelves. If you're a parent, then small, accessible shelves can be a necessity. Playroom shelves are an easy DIY project that instantly helps organize all the toys a kid collects over the years. We designed simple shelves that only use one 4x8 plywood sheet, a jigsaw, and some screws, and can be built in an afternoon. With a few added cloth bins, the playroom shelves are a sturdy, simple solution to help keep all the kid toys organized and accessible. We try to minimize the amount of toys we receive as gifts, so these shelves don't become a disaster over time and stay organized. Tip 4. Use vertical space and get items off surfaces. Wall space can be a game changer for organizing your home or garage. A simple DIY task like adding wall-mounted shelves, a hanging system, or even just screws or nails to hang items in an organized way on a wall can clear up a lot of space.
Tip 4.1. Add shelving. DIYing some shelving can help you organize by stacking and using vertical space. Add shelving to a pantry, a hall closet, or a laundry room to get items off surfaces while still keeping them accessible. Sometimes you may have existing shelving, but it's not exactly the height or spacing you need. Don't be afraid to change it to have it organized the way you want. We had a closet with some homemade shelves, but then we got an electric composter, which was too tall to fit. So we moved the shelves to fit and reorganized the closet to function with the new items.
Tip 4.2. Build some custom storage shelves. Even though we try to live without a bunch of unnecessary stuff, we still have items that need storing, like baby stuff, seasonal decorations, and gardening supplies. DIY storage shelves can be customized to fit your bins and are fairly easy to build. We have plans for these storage shelves available that come with a worksheet to help you customize them to meet your needs. We'll leave a link to these and everything else we mention in the description below the video. Tip 4.3. Just add screws into the studs or screw a board into the wall. This is one of the easiest ways to get items off the floor and costs next to nothing. Start by grouping similar items that could hang on a wall together. Then find the studs with a stud finder. You can drill screws directly into the studs for individual items to hang on. Or for several items, you can screw a board to the studs to give yourself more flexibility in where you put screws to hang your items. Then hang everything up. This makes a huge difference to declutter a space and makes everything much easier to access.
Tip 4.4. Build a French cleat system to hang large or frequently used tools. French cleats are one of the simplest DIY ways to hang tools on the wall and create a flexible organization system. Simply cut out a 1x3 or 2x4 to a length that fits on your wall, and then cut it in half at a 45 degree angle on the table saw. The top part of the cleat is attached to the tool or object, while the bottom cleat is attached to the wall. You can create little boxes or jigs to hold odd items and then attach the cleat to the back of that. It also helps to add a vertical block where necessary to keep the top cleat hanging straight and not tip out. I find that these are great scrap wood projects for when you have an extra hour or two in the shop. Then just add the tool or object with the top cleat onto the cleat that is attached to the wall. The best part is that it's super easy to rearrange or add items to this DIY organization system. The same system can be used for all kinds of different applications. We even used it to hang the headboard panels and floating nightstands in one of our recent builds. If you want to see that video, click on the banner at the top of this one.
Tip 5. Add labels. One of the easiest DIY organization tips is to just create some labels as you organize things. I don't know about others, but I've found if I give it a couple months, I'll totally forget where something goes or what's in a bin. Simple DIY labels keep my brain in order and help my family find items and put them back in their designated location. Using a printed label template works great. Handwritten labels work just as well. Tip 6, make bins out of scrap wood. Now that we have some labels, we could use some bins to put them on. There always seems to be some wood scraps laying around a garage or workshop, so put them to good use. Make some easy DIY bins from scrap wood to hold loose items on a shelf and keep them organized with other similar items. Measure out the depth of the shelf where the box will sit and the width of the widest item. Cut the scrap wood pieces to size and then glue them together. If your scraps are too thin, double them up to make a stronger box. We made several storage bins from leftover quarter-inch plywood to hold our glue and measuring tools on our open shelf in our workshop. It keeps everything together and looks nicer too. Adding labels gives it a nice finishing touch and helps you and others remember where to put it back.
Tip 7. Make drawer organizers from scrap wood or chipboard. Purchasing a lot of drawer organizers can be expensive, but they might not always fit perfectly for your drawer. A quick DIY utilizing some scrap wood or chipboard can create a custom drawer organizer that can be accomplished in about an hour. First, empty the drawer and purge unused items. Then strategize and lay out how each item can best fit in the drawer to maximize space. Measure and cut the pieces to form your dividers. A quick half-lap joint works well to keep everything spaced and makes assembly a breeze. Just slot them all together and then fill the drawer back up with the items you kept.
Ta-da! Easy homemade drawer organizer.
Tip 8. Make a spice organizer. Okay. This DIY may only be for nerds like us who have a 3D printer. We created a spice rack design that slides out of a cabinet and then rotates, so you can see all the spices at the same time. Then printed out a couple of sets on our home 3D printer. Quick install later, and we had some DIY pull-out spice racks in our kitchen cabinets. We've made the design files available for free to anyone who wants to download them. You'll find the link below this video as well. You can also look for secondhand spice rack organizers on places like eBay or Facebook Marketplace, or purchase a new one online.
Tip 9. Use decor items that you already have. Simple cloth cubes work great for toy storage, like on our playroom storage shelves. But typically you seem to purchase those for a specific space. However, you'd be amazed at what you likely already have in your home. So try shopping your home first to find items to help you organize the space. Decor items like bins and baskets are always an obvious choice, but consider trays, crocks, and vases as well. Going this route can save you money and enhance your space at the same time. Tip 10, use a found item. A branch can be a beautiful found item to use as decor. But with a little DIY, it can also be a functional item as well. We added hooks to this one to turn it into a jewelry holder. Simply pre-drill some holes along the branch, add some small hooks, and then attach it to the wall utilizing a screw and some wire. Tip 11, repurpose an old item. Shopping your home for useful organization items may mean you have to think a little outside the box. An old wine rack not being used to hold wine makes a great holder for reusable water bottles. It also allows them to stack vertically so you can easily see and access each one. It's a beautiful mix of using an item we already had and utilizing vertical space. Speaking of reusing an old item, tip 12, reuse food jars for storage. Emptied food jars make a great way to store dried herbs from our terraced vegetable garden, or dividing out some baking goods from our bulk stash. We love the look of this easy DIY and jars on our live edge wood floating shelves in our kitchen.
To reuse old food jars, simply wash out and remove the label on the jar. I found that every adhesive used on jars is different, making some easier to remove than others. Some can be removed by soaking the jars, but my favorite trick is slathering it with peanut butter, letting it sit overnight, and then rinsing it off. This has worked almost every time with no sticky residue left. Then, throw the jar and the lid in the dishwasher for an easy clean, or wash it by hand. Another way to organize with empty food jars can be using them to hold miscellaneous pieces in a garage like nuts, bolts, drywall anchors, and random screws. You can attach them to the underside of a shelf, and this helps keep your surfaces clear and makes it easier to clean sawdust off a workbench too. Just ensure you use two screws to attach the lid to the underside of the shelf or cabinet. This way the lid stays in place and doesn't rotate. Then all you have to do is screw the jar onto the lid. This is an easy DIY organization and can be done in just an hour or two, assuming you've taken the time to collect the jars already. Bonus tip, control your cords. Dangling in loose cords can be hazardous in a garage or workshop. A good way to clean this up is by securing your power strips and chargers to a vertical surface. Most of them have holes on the bottom face for exactly this purpose. Once they're up, you can then manage your cords with a staple gun where possible. Just make sure that the staple is wider than the cord so that you don't accidentally puncture the cord. It can even be in a fun linear pattern like we did for our battery chargers. And if you need to run cords across your shop, consider running them along the ceiling with hooks in order to eliminate any trip hazards and keep them out of the way.
Well, hope these tips help you find ways to DIY organize your home, garage, or workshop. But now, a serious question. Do you guys ever have trouble getting the printer labels to print out correctly? I think ours hates us. Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, then you'll love seeing how we put these organization ideas to work in our small workshop. Click on this link to check out our small workshop tour. Thanks for watching!